How much is all of that? 10,000?
25,000.
Be reasonable, okay,
yeah,
please.
Oh no, I thought you said it was 5,000. No, hell, I should pay 30 for that, 30 for that, and 20 for that.
Dennis is fighting with them. A riot's about to break out at the market.
I don't have any more money, man. I don't have no more shillings. I really don't.
Before Dennis and Rob start an international incident, let's see how their way around the world is shaping up.
This is crazy!
Reality star Boston Rob Mariano.
This job is a pain in the ass, you know that?
Woo! And monster trucker Dennis Anderson have built, bagged, and borrowed 33 ways.
Holy!
Going from Southern California to Africa's Lake Tanganyika. Now they have a new destination, the world-famous markets of the island nation of Zanzibar.
You're right, this was a stupid idea.
Rob Mariano and Dennis Anderson are circling the globe using 80 forms of transportation without repeating a single one. It's around the world in 80 ways.
You gotta be kidding me.
What needs to be done here? What can I do?
I really don't know. I gotta figure out what's wrong with it, dude.
The boys are starting out in Zambia. The first leg of this trip will be a ferry ride almost the entire length of Lake Tanganyika, 350 miles to the town of Kigoma in Tanzania.
It doesn't take a mechanic to realize that the thing's old.
But first, they have to make it to the ferry landing. We thought a truck would be a good way to get them started.
There's all kinds of stuff leaking over here.
A broken truck.
This motor's got a lot of miles on it. You can see there's an injector leaking up here. And you see these leaf springs on here? This thing is actually set up to haul 2.5 tons. They have a stack of springs on this thing, so it'll haul 5 tons. The tie rod end's even been beefed up with a piece of angle iron.
Ever since cars and trucks hit the road, their owners have done their best to drive them into the ground, but some just refuse to stop going. The current record holder for most miles clocked in a car is 2.8 million. All the boys have to cover is about 20 in order to catch their ferry, but that means it's time for Mr. Gravedigger to show off some of those first-class gearhead skills he's been flaunting.
Any mode of transportation that's got a motor in it, I guarantee you I can get it rolling. I think this is probably one of the malfunctions is the fuel shutoff.
A fuel shutoff? Can you fix it, Dennis?
Yeah, I think so, dude.
In no time at all, the Maverick mechanic zeroes in on the trouble spot.
Ho, 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 ho.
I can't hear you, what?
Try it again.
Man, almost, Dennis. What's going on?
The plunger and the fuel pump's messing up here.
All right, try it again, Rob. There it is, you got it. What the hell is going on? Dude, everybody's climbing on the van. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Why are all these people getting on? Are you seeing what's going on now?
It's because they probably were already on the truck when it broke down.
Zambia is one of the world's poorest nations. Around here, a truck about to hit the road is a chance to hitch a free ride, as long as you can hold on.
Okay, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Oh, there's no power steering.
Yeah.
Can you believe these guys just jumped on top?
You're gonna hit these power lines. You gotta watch it, man. You're gonna drag somebody off. Can you see out of this mirror?
Yeah, I can see your arm. Coming through, coming through!
Rob barrels down the road like a Boston bus driver.
How about shifting a little bit so you're not over-revving the motor?
Not even at 3,000 RPMs.
But his co-pilot is less than impressed with his driving skills.
You're killing the clutch.
I'm not even touching the clutch.
I know you're not, but can't you hear it slip?
Oh,
man. Like that right there, it's slipping. And when
what
it
am
does
I supposed
that,
to do, knock him off the
hill?
No,
you gotta go easy, gradually. Don't do it so rough.
Okay.
You have to ease down on it.
Driving this daisy over here again. Oh, man, this guy looks serious.
He is.
Just wave and smile. Hi! Okay. Just pretend like you don't know what's going on.
I say it stops, we just keep going. Look, just ignore them.
One thing the boys might want to consider as they approach this roadblock.
Oh man, we're really getting pulled over.
Yep.
The area they're in has seen a lot of incidents with bandits posing as police. They pull over drivers and demand money on the spot.
You have money? I got very little.
Those who refuse pay a bigger price.
Just remember to smile.
Yes, sir. We kind of borrowed the truck and we just got it going and they were on it.
Ask him if he'll cut us a break one time, a warning. What's going on, Dennis?
I arrested you to the police station.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry?
I didn't know.
We pay your fine.
Come on.
Don't know me.
One time, please.
Driver, what's your name?
Rob.
Ram.
Rob.
Give me a spelling.
R-O-B.
B. And your father's name?
My father's name?
Robert.
Your
last name.
Robert.
Your
last my
name.
Last name. Anderson.
Anderson.
A-N-D.
Hey guys.
The cops turned out to be real and really angry. Before our stars wound up in the clinker, we stepped in to smooth things out. A police van is one way to travel we don't want them to take. They were forced to ditch the truck, but allowed to continue.
Dennis, we don't need that truck. We'll be all right once we get over this hill. We can ride these all the way to Zanzibar. Well, maybe not.
The boys found these wooden bikes on top of the truck.
Let's go. Come on. It's all yours, brother.
Only one out of 40 in this part of Africa can afford a real bicycle, so people use these heavy homemade ones instead.
Just sit on it, dude. Look at it.
They're not so much for riding as they are for hauling. They're used to transport cargo, anything from lumber to water to coffee beans.
Hey, can I hold on the back? Go, 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 go! Go! All right.
After logging two ways to travel...
Man, it's been a long day, huh?
A cargo truck and a wooden bike.
This place looks cool, though, huh?
Dennis and Rob stop at a hotel for some well-earned rest.
Man, I hate this scooter.
A new day brings the promise of a new way. They've reached the ferry landing on Lake Tanganyika.
Fuma, 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 where do you are? Fuma, 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 come on. Fuma, 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 fuma.
Before they board, the always curious Dennis participates in a local spiritual cleansing ritual.
Woo! Hallelujah! Get all those spirits out. He's a pain in the ass to travel with. Get them all out.
Woo! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Yeah! I feel good. All right. Thank y'all.
Where did you find these guys?
Don't worry about it. I looked them up in the Yellow Pages.
The boys' next way is a truly unique piece of nautical history, the Liemba. Built in a German shipyard and then sent to Africa in 500 crates, the crates made their way to the lake in 1903. Christened as the Graf von Gratzen, it was retrofitted to be a gunboat during World War I.
This is the first cruise that you and I have ever been on together.
Don't get sweet on me now, Dennis.
Here we are. We're in Lake Tanganyika.
Well, how are we going to get to Zanzibar?
Let's get off the boat at Kigoma and head east.
All right,
Zanzibar is like the rumor where Freddie Mercury was born.
Oh, yeah? I don't even know who Freddie Mercury is, but I'm up for anything right now, man.
You know, Freddie Mercury, lead singer of Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody, We Are the Champions.
Yeah, the lead singer of Queen.
Whoa, 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 hold on. We don't have the rights to that.
Right, all right. Well, let's go there. That sounds good.
But before Rob gets to visit his hero's birthplace...
How do we get down there? That's a cargo hold. Well, here it is, ladder. I'll check it out, Dennis. You wait up here.
He checks out the 100-year-old boat they're on.
Ah, dude, this is awesome! We get some shuffleboard going on. It's huge. Come on, let's see what else there is.
All right.
Is this the engine room?
Yeah, engine room. Follow me.
Come on.
The two engines and the two generators.
That's right. These two are powering the ship. That right there is a port side generator, and that's a starboard side generator.
Get out of here. I'm going down.
The Liemba started out as a steam-powered vessel, but was converted to diesel in the 1970s. Hardly a speed demon, it tops out at 8.5 knots, about 10 miles an hour, and that's with a tailwind. All their exploring has made the boys hungry.
What's that?
I think it's beef.
And on this trip, even a meal can be an adventure into the unknown.
It doesn't look like beef to me.
Do they eat horses here, a mule? It might be a tough mule.
Could be dog. All that's gonna make you sick later.
I got a cast iron stomach, though.
Just don't say I didn't warn you.
Oh, man. I gotta go to the bathroom.
I told you, Dennis.
Is this a first-class man toilet?
Yes.
Ooh, God, this place is rot, dude. You gotta wash my hands in that. Oh, God. Unbelievable. It doesn't even have a toilet. You got to stand up. It's got foot pods.
When it comes to bathroom plumbing, Americans are spoiled. We don't know squat about how the rest of the world lives and goes. Sit-down toilets were developed so kings and queens wouldn't have to squat to do their business. As they became cheaper, everyone wanted a throne of their own. It's all a learning experience for the gastronomically challenged Dennis.
So I guess you get up here like this. Oh my God. There ain't no way, man. I'm crapped down both legs trying to do this.
Seriously, dude, I don't want to see this. Close your eyes for a minute.
Oh. You know what? If that's a first class toilet, I'd just soon go over the side of the ship. First class my ass.
Coming up.
What the hell is going on here?
The boys are traveling up Lake Tanganyika in a banged up, rusty old tub of a ferry boat.
What the hell is going on here?
At first, there were hardly any passengers, but now, as the ship makes its way north, hundreds are coming aboard.
I can't believe this, dude. All of these people are coming out. This thing doesn't even look like a seaworthy anymore. So many people on here.
Along the lake, there are few roads and no docks. So the only way to take this ferry is to get out on the water, flag it down, and climb aboard.
Hey, Rob. Rob. Dude, you got to come out and see this, man.
Okay. I'm going to get dressed, and I'll be right up.
Oh, my goodness.
What happened, Dennis? It wasn't this full last night when I went to bed.
Dude, I'm telling you, they have loaded some people onto this thing.
It's like half of Tanzania's on this boat.
Captain, how you doing? We're still on schedule? How many more people? How many more?
Now we are just dropping people now.
Oh, we're dropping people off?
It's enough now.
It looks like there's a couple coming on.
It's enough now.
It's enough?
Now it's enough.
Finished, and now?
The capacity of the ship is 600 passengers, now we have all about 500.
Oh, we have a 500.
500 passengers, yeah.
All right, Captain, thanks. 500, my ass.
Yeah.
It's about all right. 1,500.
That's right, it's 600 plus 500.
I can't believe they filled the whole thing up.
The weight limit on the Liemba is 200 tons.
Unbelievable, dude.
But you won't find any scales out here.
And they're still loading this thing, man. Every one of these straw-woven baskets are full of dried fish.
But there's no way there's enough lifeboats on this ship. If anything happens, we're going down. It's nuts.
In this part of the world, ferry disasters are sadly not an uncommon thing. On September 10th, 2011, an overcrowded ferry capsized off the coast of Zanzibar, killing 203 people. There were 800 passengers on board at the time, far over the ship's legal limit.
It's a safety plan. Two lifeboats for 39 people each. What about the other people on board? Oh my God, look at all the people. It's like wall to wall.
Unbelievable, dude.
Can't go anywhere.
They're not worried about no safety here. This is about survival. There is not one life jacket on these things. No kind of flotation device. Stuff that just absolutely does not go on in the States. They're just surviving.
Arriving in Kigoma, Rob and Dennis feel lucky to be finally getting off the ship. This is the last time they'll have to travel like this, but they know that for these people, it's a way of life.
The SS Liam, that was one exciting way right there.
Landlubbers once again. The boys plan on catching a diesel train out of Kigoma to one of the natural wonders of the world, East Africa's Serengeti.
Excuse me, this is a train station? This is it here?
Yes.
Thank you. We gotta find out what time the next train leaves. Yeah. Are you the station manager?
No, I'm assistant.
Oh, the assistant?
Yes.
Good enough. What time does the train leave?
5 p.m. every Sunday and Thursday.
What's today?
Tuesday.
Seems like the trip is starting to get to our Globetrotters.
Tomorrow? Not till 5 o'clock tomorrow.
They've shown up over 24 hours early for their train.
Yeah, that's not gonna
work.
We can't
do that.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Yeah, that's way too long.
I don't even know what day of the week it is.
I don't know, I thought it was Tuesday, man. I don't know.
We needed to get the boys moving, so we put them on another plane. It won't count, but it's the fastest transport to their next way, the 12,000 square mile area of East Africa called the Serengeti, a Maasai word for endless plains. It's home to the largest mammal migration in the world. Rob and Dennis are gonna see it in a way few do.
I'm excited. I've never been on a hot air balloon. I tell you what, Dennis, I think this is a better idea than the Liam boat.
I think so too, man. It's a little scary, but I hope this thing just stays up with a land and some lions.
Rob! Come on! Get in, Rob! Let's go!
We're getting ready for blast off! Here comes the launch! Dude, this is a huge balloon, and I hope it keeps going because we're in the middle of the Serengeti. If this thing touches down, we could be eaten.
Here we go! Here we go!
Up, up, and away!
Here we go! Here we go! Woo-hoo!
Woo-hoo! This is freaking awesome, Rob.
The physics that make a hot air balloon work are simple. When heated, air rises. A burner raises the air temperature inside the balloon, making it lighter than the surrounding air. A vent at the top of the balloon enables the pilot to release hot air and land.
Look at all the zebras up there.
The zebras.
There's a whole herd of stuff going. Look at that.
Oh, look at the elephant.
He's hustling, man. It's kind of a young-looking elephant. Look at the giraffe right here on the road. That's why we had to raise up higher to get over him.
Dude, this is awesome. This is a way to travel, though.
That's exactly what Pilatre de Rozier thought. The man who invented the hot air balloon back in 1783, the French scientist had as his first passengers a sheep, a duck, and a rooster. Fast forward to 1960, and you've got Captain Joe Kittinger setting the record for the highest balloon flight at 102,000 feet. He celebrated his achievement by jumping out, landing himself another record, highest altitude parachute jump. He fell for 4 minutes and 36 seconds, reaching a maximum speed of 614 miles per hour. Now that's a way to travel.
Hey, what do we do if we have to go to the bathroom?
You have to hold it, man. Sorry.
What if I can't hold it? I guess I could go through this little hole right there.
Ah, Dennis.
All right. Bombards
away. That's gross, dude. You're going to hit the elephant.
Look, no, it's spraying. It's going back.
Hey, can I drive this thing?
Rob.
What?
No.
I want to drive it.
No.
You want to try?
Yes, please.
Can I see your license?
My license is in America. Okay. Give me the instruction first.
Oh, God, here we go.
I'll show you.
One burner. This hand?
And this one here.
All right.
Just do it.
Just
now.
Tell me when.
It's going down. Okay. You better give it a burp.
Get the feeling for it. Hold on.
It's going down.
Rob. Getting the feeling.
Give it a burp.
Feeling.
Go, 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 go.
Go, go. It's still falling. You better give it a burp. It's going down. Seriously.
That's it.
That's it?
That's enough.
Beneath?
Fly level, yeah.
All right, we're coming in for a crash landing. Is this going to be a crash landing?
It's not that smooth.
I noticed we don't have any wheels on this thing, so how is it going to land?
Please take your landing position.
Okay.
Okay, everyone, are you ready?
Oh!
Coming up.
This is the most ridiculous freaking way yet.
You know what? You're right. This was a stupid idea. You win this one. This is what I've been waiting for, the landing.
Please take your landing position.
Okay.
Okay, everyone, are you ready?
When it comes to landing a hot air balloon,
this is going to be a bumpy landing, I can tell.
A rough landing is a good one.
Come and mounting on your side.
Oh! The wind knocked out of me. Wasn't expecting that one.
There's another one, seriously.
Oh! All right, but that's enough.
Nice. We're riding a big elephant turd, y'all.
Oh!
We're getting dumped in an elephant turd.
Woohoo! Oh. Yeah, Muhammad!
That was an awesome way, Rob.
Yeah, it was.
That landing was pretty bumpy, though.
Well, that was exciting. You caught me by surprise.
I know it. I didn't think it was going to bump that hard.
The wind carried the boys 30 miles deeper into the Serengeti.
Where's our safari vehicle?
Once on the ground, they wasted no time.
Yeah. Want safari?
Yes.
All right.
All right. Thank you.
Rob had prearranged for a safari car to pick them up.
I want to see lions, rhino, buffalo, zebra, giraffe.
He's got a wildlife agenda.
Here we go.
Crocodile, hippo.
Just in case you haven't met, I'm Dennis, and this is Bossy Rob. He'll be bossing you around the rest of the day.
I'd also like to see cougar, cheetah, and whatever else you can find.
Rob is doing his best impression of an ugly American.
Make it snappy.
And he's really good at it.
I wonder what he thinks of you. It's like, you know, when you're so demanding and bossy.
Nah, he knows I'm joking. You can't take things so serious.
Right.
Look around at where we are. We're at the Serengeti. Petro, I don't see any animals. Can we go faster? I want to see the big five. Leopard, lion, buffalo, elephant, and rhino.
I'm sorry, Petro.
Look at these birds, though, dude. What are they?
What kind of bird is that?
Quarry bastard.
What quarry bastard? Can we make them fly?
Yes.
Dennis, run after them. Make them fly.
I'm not getting out of here.
Okay, never mind with the little stuff, Petro. I want to see elephant, rhino, zebra, and also the hippopotamus.
Yeah. He knows. You've already told him this like 2 or 3 times, Rob.
I know, but we're not going anywhere near it. He keeps showing us birds.
No, I know.
Came
we got
all the way
get
to
there.
The Serengeti. I want to see
animals.
After driving 50 miles across the Serengeti, the boys made good progress eastward toward Zanzibar, and Rob's about to cross one off his wildlife wish list.
Look, there's a Cape Buffalo.
There's a Cape Buffalo.
Go to the Cape Buffalo.
That's one of the big five. Look at how big it is.
Oh, there's another one. There's two of them.
Look at the size of those horns. That thing will knock this vehicle right over.
Yeah, that's a lot of meat hanging on those bones.
Baboons.
Yeah.
There's warthog.
Nice.
Impala. Impalas are delicious.
Yeah, but I know that one's name right there is Yum Yum. These are southern elephants right here, Rob.
What's a southern elephant?
There's a southern elephant, there's an east elephant.
No, there's an African elephant, there's an Indian elephant.
No, the eastern elephant, he's actually the bigger bulls, they're about 4 to 6 inches taller at the shoulder, too.
Oh, 4 to 6 inches.
Yes.
We're talking about an animal that stands 10, 11 feet high.
Right.
You're talking about 4 to 6 inch difference.
Yeah, yeah, it's like, okay, 10'4" then, right? That's an eastern redneck elephant there. Because their poop down here around the eastern border, their poop is greener. And it's grayer in the south.
You're just trying to sell me on something. Two down, three to go. All we need now is the rhino, the lion, and the leopard. Get to it.
Our boys drove over 200 miles looking for the last three of the big five.
Been driving around for like 3 hours. What's the deal?
With Rob complaining the whole ride.
Did you see the rhino? The leopard?
There you go again.
Let's go.
Had they seen a lion, the driver probably would have thrown Rob at it.
Petra, what are we doing in town? Why are we stopping?
Instead, he simply dumps them out on the street.
You pissed him off. I knew you were going to do that.
Get out.
Okay, fine.
All right. Sorry, Petro.
Come on, we'll find another way. Sorry, buddy.
Look at this. We're at the market. Perfect. We'll find something else here.
The boys were hoping to be driven to the Maasai village about a mile further down the road. But Rob's big mouth cut their trip short. Now they need to find another way.
What is that? What are they doing, chicken? Look at these guys on these stilts.
Oh man, that looks cool. I want to try that. Dude, let's go get some wood and we'll make some.
Oh God, dude, how far are we going to go on these things?
Come on, let's go have some fun. Look, you love the market. Who are you kidding?
I know. I do.
This is it. This is what they made them out of.
All right.
One more.
Yes.
All right.
I don't know about this, Rob. I'm kind of clumsy on these things, dude.
Stilts actually date back to the ancient Greeks. They were a practical way for shepherds to get a better view of their flocks. Eventually, stilts evolved into a way for townspeople to stay above the soggy ground in their everyday activities. Because streets doubled as sewers, some quick-thinking 16th century prostitute devised the first platform shoes to keep their dresses out of the muck.
You know, we still gotta get to Zanzibar, Dennis.
We gotta find a different way than this, I can tell you that. This got me sweating, dude.
Coming up.
You gonna eat the goat?
No.
Oh my goodness, they're really gonna do it. Oh no. Let him go, let him go, let him go.
Besides being at each other's throats,
what am I supposed to do, knock them off?
Rob and Dennis managed to eke out four new ways as they traveled to the island of Zanzibar. It started in a broken cargo truck.
We're driving Miss Daisy over here again.
Then they two-wheeled it on a couple of wooden bikes.
Hey, can I hold on the back? Go, 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 go.
They shipped passage on a 100-year-old, very overcrowded ferry boat. And floated above the Serengeti in a hot air balloon.
Dude, this is awesome. This is a way to travel, though.
Now, with less than 30 miles to the East African coast and the Indian Ocean, they're still hoofing it on some homemade stilts. their immediate destination to meet up with a tribe of Maasai people at a nearby village.
You know, Rob, we've been several ways. This is the most ridiculous freaking way yet.
It's not that bad.
Bull.
As a way to travel, the guys are finding it tough going on their homemade stilts.
And this is your idea, pretty
you know
boy.
What? It wasn't my idea. My idea was to go see the Big Five.
No, but you ran your mouth.
If I didn't speak up, we wouldn't have seen any of the Big Five. You know what? You're right. This was a stupid idea. You win this one. Man, I hope they have some food here. You think they have a bar?
It don't look like it, dude. I bet you they can cook a mean goat, though. I'm over these damn things. And that's another way.
That was my fault. I'm sorry about those.
Hi. How y'all doing?
How are you?
Not everything on their trip is about ways to travel. Sometimes you have to stop and take a look around. In this part of Africa, there's no better place than a Maasai village.
We have to find out who's in charge here and see if they have something to eat. Who's in charge? No English?
No.
Do you read lips? See if they read lips.
Your daddy, 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 mama, baby. Yeah, your daddy.
Look, there's some guys tending to the goats. You want to talk to them?
Look, right here, there's daddy.
Oh, you can just tell. He's got the swagger. You know, I know about these people, Dennis. These are the Maasai.
Look, here's what I like about them. Check his shoes out. Chief.
Hello.
We were wondering if you had anything to eat. Food?
Maya?
Food? Yama. Yama, yeah.
I'm Rob. This is Dennis.
Kanuna.
Kanuna.
Senchukut.
Naitami. Naitami? I'm not going to remember these.
The Maasai are a nomadic tribe and forced to migrate every few months in order to find grazing for their livestock. But all that moving requires a lot of effort. So anything that makes it easier to pick up and go, like a large family to pack everything up, and extra livestock to carry it, is extremely valuable. A man's wealth is determined by his offspring and his cattle.
Why are we holding hands like this? I gotta hold hands? This makes me a little uncomfortable. I gotta be honest with you. I mean, I'm cool with it. This is the tradition. I'll go with it. It's kind of a moment with the sunset and all. I got a soft spot for goats. I used to have one. His name was Vinny. Why is that funny? Okay, we're gonna all hold hands? Is he gonna hold hands too?
What do you call it? What do you call it? Grave digger. Grave digger. Grave digger. Woo! Yeah.
Okay, what are we doing? You gonna eat the goat? No. You want me to catch him? Oh, we're still holding hands. Okay.
I see us.
There. Okay. Yes. Yes, that one.
Yes.
Yes, the old one.
Yes.
Oh my goodness, they're really gonna do it. Oh no. No, 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 no. No, 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 never mind. Let him go. Let him go, let him go, let him go. No, 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 no. It's too close to me. It's okay. One more night, no problem. We don't have to eat. It's okay. You guys do it after. No problem. Let's go. Everybody in.
What is this? Can somebody tell me what that is?
What is that?
Dennis.
Yeah.
I have some bad news.
What's that?
There's not going to be any food. I'll talk to you about the food later.
Okay.
But let's say our goodbyes.
All right.
And move on.
Okay.
Thank you
bye-bye.
Very much.
We love you guys. That means bye. We love you.
Man, you wouldn't believe it. They had a goat, and they were gonna kill it for us to eat. Oh, God. I just couldn't do it.
So what'd they do, laugh at you?
Coming up.
Whoa, 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 I forgot, I'm on this side, sorry.
damn it. I'm going the wrong way.
It's been a long few days and over 1,500 miles, but Rob and Dennis have made it to the coast of Tanzania and are now within striking distance of the island nation of Zanzibar.
This is it, Dennis. This is the Indian Ocean. And that right over there, that's Zanzibar. Well, that's where we need to go then. Well, look at the sailboats out there.
These are like the traditional dhow boats. These were the old boats that they used back in the slave trading days. We might be able to get one pretty cheap with the exchange rate. Want to talk to this guy?
Yeah.
The dhow is a primitive but proven seaworthy boat design used throughout Asia, Northern Africa, and the Middle East. They're used to carry cargo, anything from fruits and vegetables to fresh water.
Excuse me. Hello?
With a little charm and a bit of cash, the boys rented a dhow boat for the day.
You want to drive? I'll shove us off.
Sure.
Now, they just have to learn how to sail it.
Hold on, here's the anchor.
Hey, this old boat's cool, man.
Instead of nails, a dhow's hull is stitched together with plant fiber. It was believed that this provided flexibility in case of a crash.
You gotta shimmy that thing up the mast.
That should come in handy for Rob and Dennis.
Come on. Hold on. We're going, we're off.
Good teamwork. Good teamwork.
Yes, sir.
We're sailing, Dennis.
Sailing.
Look at how far away from the land we are already. We'll be there in no time.
Zanzibar, baby, here we come. Yes. Pull the rudder to you.
You can't stand it, can you? You cannot stand it that I'm
just
driving.
I know, but just all you gotta do is pull it to you.
No,
I wanna,
I'm driving, Dennis. You work the sail.
All right. Yee-hoo. You hear that? Nothing, dude. Nothing but pure wind power. I like this.
It's kind of like a taste of choice moment between guys. Look. You know what that is, Dennis?
It's Zanzibar.
We're almost there. Can you believe we made it?
Yeah, baby. There it is, Zanzibar.
The dhow boat took the boys across 25 miles of Indian Ocean to the island of Zanzibar.
Let's do it.
Look at this up here. Look at that.
Hey. Oh, nice squid. Will you put your pants down? You think you're like Tom Sawyer.
I don't care. I don't want this fungi on my pants. Aren't we gonna go to your buddy's place? What are you calling, Freddie Mercury's?
Yeah, Freddie Mercury. He's not my buddy, but I wanna see his birthplace.
Rob is still determined to visit the birthplace of the rock star who gave spandex a good or bad name, depending upon how you feel about synthetic stretchy bodysuits.
Well, how are we gonna get there?
Those. Wait here, let me go talk to the guy.
All right, that'll work.
I wanna rent two bikes. Can I rent this one and this one?
Yes.
Okay, cool. We're good, Dennis. You know what we should do?
After watching these guys go halfway around the world, it should be pretty obvious that the next words out of Rob's mouth will be...
We should race.
Okay.
Because of the maze-like streets, the people prefer bikes and scooters to get around. It's not uncommon to see a scooter loaded with twice the weight of the person driving it.
All right, let's go find something heavy.
The boys thought they'd keep it real and pack on the pounds of each other's scooters before they race.
How much is all of that?
$10,000.
Nothing like some good old rocks.
Oh, yeah.
I want to buy something very big and bulky and heavy. Oh, charcoal. Perfect. I wonder how Dennis is doing negotiating on his own.
What is that? I mean, that one's a 10.
Oh, no, I thought you said it was 5,000 for them, for that. I already had those. I already bought them.
I got the locals helping me and working with me. Dennis is fighting with them. A riot's about to break out at the market.
I don't have any more money, man. I don't have no more shillings. I really don't, okay?
Put this in the front, like so.
We got it. We need to get the hell out of here.
So I see you. It looks like you're starting to fight over there.
Let's go.
They escaped the market before the UN had to be brought in. But neither one has any clue where the hell Freddie Mercury's child they're halfway to their magic number.
Probably the one thing that stuck out in my mind the most about traveling to Africa was when we took a hot air balloon up over the Serengeti.
The takeoff was a little bumpy and the landing was a little bumpy, but I've got to say, man, once we were just drifting across, I just felt like I was riding on a cloud. It was the most awesome scene all the way across to Africa.
We saw the Great Migration passing underneath us. I mean, that's something that you read about in books and you hear about in television. And here I am living it, being able to bring it to everybody else at home. An awesome, awesome experience, one that I'll never forget.